Junior, you didn't happen to see the... Oh, thanks, Snooky. Happen to see any sign of the birthday boy?
Did someone say cake? Cherry meringue sugar stuffed power pellet a l'orange?
You shouldn't have.
Well, you only turned 25 once.
It just sounds so old.
Aw, sweetie, you're only as 25 as you feel.
Thanks, honey. You and Junior are the best presents I ever had. And you're right. I look fantastic.
Is something wrong?
Honey, my pack sense is tingling.
There. You're not 24 anymore, you know.
But I'm not doing anything!
Go! Work with me, you spark-showering excuse from microcircuitry!
Okay, honey, it was funny once.
Don't panic! Everything's under control! I don't think it'll happen!
Oh well, at least this birthday's still better than my 20th.
Happy birthday, dear.
Who's there?
Pac-Man!
The signal's bad here. Some idiot teleported me into a pit.
Is that clear? You shouldn't rush to judgments, Pac-Man. Teleportation is not so easy.
Orson? Is that you? Are you by any chance the idiot of whom we speak?
I had pinpoint control of the porter until you squirmed. I would port you again, but I can't lock on. Where are you?
I'm in some sort of landfill pit. There's green goo, some trash-looking junk, and it smells really bad in here. Really.
Oh, you're down there. Ew. Rather you than me. Make your way upwards. I'll try to think of some way to help.
What about the monsters? There's usually monsters at times like this. Aha, monsters, check. These are the guys that smell so bad, huh? Who dumps a giant, busted robot? Who made all this weird junk? Orson, why am I here?
Would you believe me if I said the whole world was in danger?
Let me get back to you on that, buddy. It looks like this weird, busted machinery still sort of works. Orson, who made these robots?
A nasty creep named Erwin. Typical megalomaniac. Hates chocolates and kittens. An only child, I think.
I know the type. Well, at least I can get across the goo now. So, what's this Erwin guy up to?
It's bad, Pac-Man. Let's just say he threatens Pac-Land, the Spectral Realm, the rest of the world, and everything else as well! Uh-oh! I'm detecting a rise in energy in your sector, Pac.
Details of my sector's energy should be between me and Miss Pac. Thank you very much.
Please, Pac-Man, do you see a... swirly thing?
Yeah, yeah. Mr. No Fun swirly thing. Check. Spewing ghosts. Check.
Not ghosts. Spectral monsters. Tougher than ghosts. You'll need a power pellet.
Whoa. Of all the ghostly things I ever ate, those are the least pleasant. I need a mint.
The spectral monsters come from the spectral realm, which is being siphoned by Erwin, which is why they're in a seriously bad mood.
The spectral realm? Don't you ghosts have something to do with that?
It's our home, too. Now can you see why I need your help? I don't know exactly what Erwin's up to, but it involves my home. which is why I'm in a seriously bad mood. Come and find me at the outpost. It's just a little bit further.
Orson, I thought you were going to teleport me.
I can't calibrate, Pac-Man. Atmospheric, interference from the, radiation. Just keep following the path. I'm not far away at all.
Another one of those rev roll plates.
This whole area was created by a race known as the Ancients, Pac-Man. It hums with their power. Even though they're long dead now, the canyon still has a life of its own.
Of course. You say that this Irwin guy is messing with the spectral realm. No wonder the spectral dudes are upset. Not only are they outcast themselves, but now their home isn't even their own.
Yes, but they're vicious little creeps anyway. So don't feel too sorry for them.
This looks arcane. Irwin's work, Orson?
Indeed not. This has been here for, my instruments suggest, a very long time. The ancients didn't want just anyone wandering around here, I guess.
So, a millennia-old puzzle, huh? My specialty! There's weird techno stuff here, Horse. Yours?
Heavens, no! Shoddy craftsmanship like that. It all belongs to Irwin. He's building spectral siphons all over the place. Keeps stockpiling raw materials. I'd like you to disrupt, distress, and otherwise blow up anything of his you see. Please.
Orson, I'd claim to be pleased to see you, but you messed up my party and threw me into a trash pit where lots of things with big pointy teeth tried to turn me into lunch.
This is serious, Pac-Man. Irwin is so hungry for power that he's siphoning energy from the spectral realm.
So what can I do?
For starters, Inky, Blinky, Pinky, and Clyde have disappeared. I fear the worst. I want you to go to the spectral realm and check things out.
A trip to a doomed place that's full of ghosts and spectral monsters. Hey, count me in.
Good. But before that, I want you to help me calibrate Talkman.
Talkman? You have a new Talkman? A new big giant robot Talkman?
More than a normal giant robot, Pac-Man. 15 tons of the most state-of-the-art bad guy smooshing technology ever balanced on legs.
Cool.
Just try not to break this one, huh?
The red wire or the blue wire? Red wire, blue wire.
Red! Blue!
For the last time, make up one of your minds!
Ask Blinky. He's the clever one.
Zipper, Inky, don't tell him nothing!
Ah, I didn't hear you come in. What do you want this time?
You ever heard of Pinky and Clyde?
No, he hasn't!
No one's heard of our friends Pinky and Clyde.
You two want to give me a break back there?
Aside from those last two ghosts, the spectral realm is almost empty. It's ready for the siphons to begin.
Ah, yes, well, thanks. It's been real. Off you go.
What about the new problem? The new yellow problem?
If you're talking about Pac-Man, our paths have already crossed.
The yellow power? He'll munch us all! We're all doomed, I tell you! Doomed!
I don't want to be doomed. I just want to go home.
Anyway, Nefarious Scheme 57 is a big fat go. Nothing can stop me now! Can I say something about two other ghosts?
They'll be dealt with.
And if Pac-Man tries to interfere, he shall rue the day he ever tried to interfere!
Cool!
I'm warning you two.
Wow. What is this place, Orson? It's weird.
If my calculations are correct, and they are, you're in the spectral realm just as planned.
So this is where all you ghosts come from. Not very homely, is it? Remind me what I'm doing here.
I've lost contact with my friends, Pac-Man. I need you to track them down. Inky, Blinky, Pinky, and Clyde? I'm sure you remember.
Yeah, first they chase me, then I chase them, then they chase me. Tracking them down will be just like old times. I'm on it.
Get your game face on, Pac-Man. I'm detecting a surge in spectral activity in your area.
What's with the spectrals?
Unhappy souls. They usually hide in the darkness of the caverns beneath the spectral realm. Irwin's siphoning seems to have stirred them up, though.
This brings back memories.
Nasty spooks at 3 o'clock, Pac-Man.
Then I've got plenty of time to... This sure is a weird place.
You weren't brought up here, Pac-Man. Now, get after those ghosts!
I hear you, buddy. Any idea where I should be heading?
Well, my last received contact from Pinky came from right at the top of this rail, so head there. I miss this place. Sadly, the spectral realm and machinery just don't go together. My experiments all went wrong. It was a mess! So I decided to move somewhere more substantial.
Looks like that's where I need to be.
Watch out behind you, Pac-Man! Thinking of the spectral realm has made me nostalgic. I remember paddling in the miasma seas as a little ghost, making fog castles and searching smoke pools for puppy mites. Oh, happy time! Pac-Man, my reading suggests a nearby ghost to rescue. Either that, or I have spaghetti sauce in my monitor.
Great, so you couldn't just port me straight to it, could you? Oh no, it's much more fun to see poor Pac-Man bounced around like a big yellow ball.
Sorry, Pac-Man. I'll give the teleporter a bit of a tweak. Now, track down that ghost for me!
End of the road. Scenic anyway. Now, if only I could find a friendly ghost to tell me which way... Eureka! I guess.
Help me!
Help who?
I said, help me!
Pinky? What are you doing here?
Being chased? What are you waiting for? Pull me up before it gets here!
It? What it?
Me, it.
What's your deal?
You may refer to me as your worst nightmare.
Pac-Man, quick, pull me up!
Be right with you! You won't push me over the edge or anything if I help Pinky up, will you?
No, Scout's honor.
Don't trust him. He's small, evil, and wants to plug me into a giant energy-sucking machine.
Any truth to that, Mr. Nightmare?
If I said yes, would you hold it against me?
Nah, look down.
Well played, my cunning yellow friend.
Less chit-chat, more pulling me up sometime today.
Don't worry, Pinky. I haven't lost a ghost yet. Hold on.
Let the games begin.
Wow! Solid ground! I recognize that stuff. I'm guessing I'm miles away from where I actually have to be, right?
Frankly, you could do with the exercise, Pac-Man. You're starting to look even more spherical than usual.
Hey, Miss Pac-Man likes me cuddly, okay? So what's with the big tower?
The first spectral siphon is somewhere within that structure. Find it and shut it down.
Hiya, Pac-Man. If we're gonna beat this Irwin guy, you're gonna need all the help you can get.
Okay.
I can see things you can't. Spectral things. Including platforms. And if I'm charged up at a spectral fountain, I can make those platforms solid enough even for you.
Hey, fella, I'm in a jam here, buddy. Little bit of monster trouble. You look like you got a mean butt bounce on you, so, you know the drill.
Sure thing, pal. Consider these monsters as good as flattened.
Wow, no kidding. You made short work of them guys.
How long did they have you pinned down?
Only a week or two. No huge problem. Except this tower tends to fall down without due care and attention.
That's what you do? Fix up Gogekka?
Sure, that's what I does. I know it back to front, up and down, in and out, all around. Say, I'll give you a buzz if you're looking lost. How's about that?
Sure, I never turn down help. And I do look lost with alarming regularity.
Hey, yellow fruit guy. What is it you're doing here, eh? Just out of curiosity, you understand?
You know a guy named Irwin? He's planted an energy site here in Gogekka, and I'm here to pull him right back down.
Oh yeah, I know the bozo. Kind of funny looking. Listen, man, I ain't happy about that siphon pool dance, so you'll be doing me another favor to get the thing off my building. This place is dangerous enough as it is.
It's not safe?
There's no part of Irwin's venture that is safe, Pac-Man. Take it from me.
I think I found the giant siphon, Ors. And I think I found the guys who are guarding it. Oh boy!
If I'm gonna restore more than one platform, I'll need to find multiple energy fountains. Sorry, Pac-Man, but I can only hold three platforms in the real world at once. If I try to solidify a fourth, then the oldest platform will disappear. There must be some fountains near here. I'd better hunt around and find them.
Irwin would never want to think small.
You two need to snap out of it. We've got a job to do, so we do the job. It's pretty straightforward. Gee, it doesn't look any prettier close up.
Blow it up then. Take out all the guards and find an access terminal. You need to hack the machine to shut it down.
Kinda hard to type with boxing gloves on, Orson. Got a plan B?
Good point. How about we try something a little more exciting? Get ready for Virtual Pac-Man!
Waka waka! And bye-bye, Mega Siphon!
Oh, thanks a lot, fella. Hey, can I get back to work now?
Sure, but be careful. Pac-Man, we have to move on now. I have a lock on five, even the Spectral Realm.
Sure thing, Ors. See you later, construction guy! Ooh, my eyes are spinning, so I'm guessing I'm back in the Spectral Realm. It's a nice surprise, Orson. Thanks!
I've located Clyde Pac-Man. He's being held somewhere in this realm. It'd be better to find him before this place collapses entirely.
Clyde? Hey, it's been a long time since I traded witticisms with Old Red. I really do feel almost nostalgic, Ors. But me? Rescuing ghosts? I tell you, it's just not natural.
Natural or not, Pac-Man, you need to do it. Clyde's a fighter, and he'll be vital in our war against Irwin. It's so sad to see this place falling apart. I had a fine life here as a young ghost. I learned basic levitation, scary and surprising, spooky noises, all here. Oh, great time.
Excuse me, Munchie?
Did I hear something, tiny squeak?
Yeah, the big red ghost gets himself all caged up, so the yellow fella gets the mark. Go on then, Munchie, mark away.
Aw, don't take it like that. It's not like I find it funny or anything, Clyde. Well, not much, only a little.
Are you okay, Clyde?
All right, that's it. I don't need rescuing. Nope, leave me here. I'll take dignity over freedom any day.
Aw, you're just no fun. Hold on a sec, I'll be right there.
Thanks, Munchie. Looks like you have your uses after all.
Hey, less of a Munchie, okay?
Easy now, I don't mean nothing by it. I'm just a little on edge because my boys Inky and Blinky have gone AWOL, and I'm betting the freak that caged me up has them too.
Right now, I'm just trying to get rid of some spectral siphons to stop this realm collapsing around our ears.
Siphons? Like machines? I ain't seen nothing like that. Just a big old swirly thing.
From within the spectral realm, a siphon's effect would be seen as a quasi-pseudo distortion of its atomic fabric. In layman's terms, swirly. Pac-Man, find that swirliness!
You seem awfully fond of the spectral realm, Ors. I guess it looks different to ghosts.
It looks different to everyone who comes here, Pac-Man. It reacts to expectation, you see. It's really a sea of potential, which is probably why it makes such a tempting target for that power-hungry Irwin.
That looks like the siphon vortex ahead, Pac-Man.
That's just a swirl. I can't hack that.
Actually, in the spectral realm, siphons are much more vulnerable. If you can knock something suitably large into the vortex, it should knock it out completely.
Sounds like when Miss Pack sucks up one of my power pellets in the vacuum cleaner. Uh-oh, but no power pellet. I hate to admit it, but I need help. I must be able to summon Clyde somehow.
Hey, that's him, the freak that tricked me into that cage.
Yeah, we met before. He's an idiot.
You're entitled to form your own subjective opinion of my intellectual faculties, Pac-Man.
I'll subject your onions to an integral fragility, you cowardly conniving conster.
I have no idea what a fragility is, but I'd like to see his onion subjected to it. Go get him, Red.
Getting ghosts to fight your battles for you? How the Neverland have sunk evil.
Keep talking, loudmouth. You're gonna get every silver bubble back with interest. Are you gonna tell me what you've done with my boys, Inky and Blinky?
Let me think. No, I'm gonna say no. Sorry about that. Careful here. It's a trick, kid. That's right.
Whoa there, Munchie. This is a job for a real fighter. Namely, the famous Ghost Ray Chancellor, Clyde. That's me.
Come on. Come on. I can have that even to be here.
If I'm coming at you kind of slow, it's because I'm busy thinking of all the things I'm gonna do.
Hey. If you want to go straight back in that cage, keep coming, empty ceremony doofus.
I'm gonna haunt you very, very clear. I hope your foot is firing for your own sake.
You do know I'm joking, right? The whole cage thing, a joke. Right? Right?
So that's an integral fragility. Neat!
Better still, Clyde's timely fragmentation destroyed the siphon. It seems that hurling a huge chunk of rock into a siphon nexus causes a huge feedback surge. That's something to remember.
No one can lock the big red in a cage and expect to remain unthrown in a swirly vortex thing. No, sir!
Whoa, you shouldn't have messed with you, Clyde.
And magnificently, that seems to have deactivated the siphon as well.
Hi, Thoran! Slapskin! Yeah! New and exciting place. Same risk of being eaten. Welcome to Pack Life. Well, I can't say that was the friendliest welcome I've ever had, Orse.
Sorry, I don't know why those guys didn't turn up on my radar. Anyway, carry along this path, Pac-Man. There should be another siphon in this area.
Where am I, by the way?
High up in the Cragstone Mountains. I have no idea why Erwin would want to build siphons here. The one in Gogeka made a kind of sense, as the fabric between real and spectral worlds is thin there. But why here? I'm flummoxed.
Never mind, Orson. I've been flummoxed from the start, and I'm doing okay. It appears to be missing a part. I'm gonna be doing a lot of this, aren't I?
Think of it as a valuable learning experience.
Wow. So quiet. Is this a ghost town?
The last registered inhabitants were a group of archaeologists who were apparently studying some local caverns. But I have no life readings now. Maybe Erwin's autonomic policy enforcement mechanoids, his robots I mean, scared them away. It looks like some of these windmills are rather dilapidated, Pac-Man. It looks like they provide power for the ropeways. So you'll have to fix them to get around the village.
Why are you surprised about the siphons here, Horse?
Any place can be siphoned from in principle. And there are plenty of places easier to set up and maintain delicate machinery than these mountains. There just has to be a reason to siphon here specifically. Okay, Pac-Man, there's the siphon. My scan suggests a heavy hostile presence this side. Maybe you should sneak around the back.
You're the brains of this team, Horse. Initiating zero identification tippy-toe protocols for undetected siphon insertion.
That sounded nothing like me.
Man, oh man, I love doing that.
Don't dilly-dally, Pac-Man. I'm getting reports of a bigger siphon. Erwin must have hidden it inside the mountain.
Looks like I'm going underground, then.
These must be the caverns those archaeologists were exploring, Pac-Man. Erwin's desire to siphon here must have something to do with these ancient catacombs.
Those things are scary. Can I go home now?
Yes, they are. No, you can't.
Meanie.
Hydratron. My stepfather made me summon it once. Once?
Give it up, Erwin. Conquering the universe never works for shrimpy megalomaniacs with mittens. It's a known thing.
Universe! That's the last straw. I've a good mind to have my army of loyalty-crazed minions disintomographicate you. Twice.
Sorry, Erwin. Zero's my limit.
This wasn't part of the plan!
Okay, I'm in. Where to now?
Looks like you're going to have to go right through the mountain. But keep on your toes, Pac-Man. Somehow I don't think Erwin's going to make this easy for you.
Oh, good heavens, you gave me quite a fright. I haven't seen another living soul down here for months, apart from the ancient guardians. And they just hiss at me. Are you lost, my little yellow friend?
Not exactly. I'm looking for a spectral siphon. Have you seen one?
A siphon, you say? Interesting, very interesting. I'd love to help you, but unfortunately my excavation rig suffered a mechanical trauma a few minutes ago, and I contrived to drop one of the keys to this door into that pit.
One of the keys?
Yes, the door requires two, and one of them is down there.
And I'm guessing you want me to get it back for you.
Could you? I say that would be splendid. When you've located the lost key, I'll drop a ladder down for you. I heard a bit of a rumpus down there. I hope you didn't get hurt.
There were monsters in the pit. It's a good job you didn't try to retrieve the key yourself.
What sort of a silly head climbs into a pit he knows to be full of monsters?
You knew about them? Why didn't you tell me?
Are you a silly head? My, my, and you look like such a nice boy. Anyway, at least we can open the door now.
Super!
Well done, my friend. A new and worthy ally.
Ah, there's still so much to learn about the ancients. I know nothing about their lives, only their deaths. Even the most intelligent people can be dumb as a duck egg when the mood takes them. Oh, yes, they can.
This cavern was one of many built by the ancients in these mountains. They built temples everywhere. Most of them are in ruins now, of course. They disappeared from the face of the planet many moons ago.
That's true, my boy, but their fate is no mystery to the trained archaeological eye. It's the oldest story, I'm afraid. A tale of greed, of tampering with mysterious forces, and then of running and screaming and dying. Oh, if these caverns could talk, my, what stories they'd have to tell. Now all they say to me is, don't go messing with forces you don't understand.
Mysterious forces? Do you mean the spectral realm? Is that why Erwin is siphoning down here? To repeat the attempts of the ancients?
Enough history already! There's work to be done!
These barrels look like they should hold charges of some kind. This is dangerous stuff to just leave lying around. A detonator! I normally never leave home without it. Man, nothing clears the head like a good explosion.
Nice work, Pac-Man. You should be able to get out of this cavern now.
But do try not to destroy too much more of this unique and beautiful natural geology.
Spectral, we must be getting close, Pac-Man.
I spy power pills. These guys won't last long.
Give it up, Pac-Man! You're never going to defeat me! So why even...
You're messing with forces you don't understand, P-Brain! The ancients wiped themselves out interfering with the spectral realm!
I know what I'm doing! The ancients were just rank amateurs! Can stone temples compare to my technology? Can forgotten rituals match the power of giant robots of doom? Of course I let you get this far, just for entertainment value. But now my minions will turn you into Pac-Man!
Now you've got rid of those nasties, I can hack you into the Siphon's virtual system, Pac-Man. Get ready!
That's one more Siphon out of commission, horse!
Good timing! There's trouble at Gogeka! Hold on to your dots!
Orson, are you finally trying to finish me off? You've ported me into the middle of an inferno!
Sorry, Pac-Man, but it seems as if Erwin has changed tactics. He set fire to the Gogeka Towers, no doubt to create a diversion. He has a sick mind, Pac-Man.
This is a nightmare! I can't fight this!
Hey! Hi, fella! Anything I can do?
You're gonna have to find the emergency sprinkler controls. Get some water on that, please. And quickly. That tower could come down at any moment. Nice going, boss. You should be able to get through now.
Pac-Man, do you hear something?
Beyond the roaring of flames and the ominous creaking of ravaged foundations, I don't believe I do.
I hear something. Ticking noise. From above you. As if there were some huge, immense, gigantic boat.
Bah?
A huge, gigantic, immense bow. Bonus! If we get the fires out quickly, that'd be a bonus!
Orson, you're weird.
Nice one, Pac-Man. Say, while you've been fighting these fires, you haven't seen any. No empty boxes marked explosives, nothing like that.
What?
No, just making sure. Orson out.
There you are. You're an elusive little seer. I've nothing but dismay, Pac-Man, except... You're doomed. You're out. You're lunch. You're toast. Because I'm saving the meat of the mocking for when you're begging me for mercy.
I'm sorry, Pac-Man can't talk to the moronic would-be evil mastermind right now. Please leave a message after the beep. Beep!
Pac-Man, the ticking! You can hear the ticking now, right?
It must be in your head, Orson. I can only hear a sort of high-pitched ringing noise with muffled explosions behind it.
Right, good, yes. Well, be ready for... I don't want to panic me. Panic you! Sorry.
Orson, you're panicking me. Please, stop being odd and get back to being helpful. Oh, no! It's a huge, immense, gigantic bonus! I mean, bomb! It's a good job you didn't warn me about this, Orson! I'd have panicked!
Pac-Man, I got an online schematic of a bomb right here. Probably a completely different type of bomb, and the diagram is in a language I can't read, but it's keeping me sane. You need to get on top of it.
Use the pistons. The activation switch is on the ledge.
Don't think you'll be getting out of here in one piece, Walmart. I'm new to interior decoration, I know. But I think the walls will look just fine painted patch yellow. Come on.
Hurry, Pac-Man! That bomb of a short fuse! Go faster, Pac-Man! You're about to get roasted! I can't watch! I can barely listen! Where's the off switch? It says here, undo screws A, B, and C. Then, it's a little picture of a duck. No, wait. It's a humanoid. He's pressing the huge button to deactivate the bomb.
Well, I did get an early heads up and all from my faithful support team.
Well, anyone can defuse a bomb. I was defusing bombs in my diapers, Pac-Man. But I promise my next challenge won't be so easy, you pellet-popping peon.
You should be able to see the outpost from there, Pac-Man. Hurry!
What's the rush, Orson? Maybe I want to enjoy the view.
I'm guessing that you can't see the approaching horde from there. Erwin's army is on its way, Pac-Man!
And if you're not here by then, Munchie, I'll have to take him on by my lonesome.
Wouldn't be right to let you have all the fun, Red. It's been a while since I defeated an army. Actually, I've never done it. Do we have a plan?
Not so much of a plan, Pac-Man, as a giant robot fitted with arms that go puncha, puncha!
Plus a gun that goes daka daka!
I'd better get a choppa chomping.
Inevitable winner calling pathetic loser! Hey, Spooks, how's life in that cozy little outpost? Ready to have it torn down around your ears?
The joke's on you, Erwin. Ghosts have no ears.
If you're relying on that little yellow sphere to save you, think again, you intellectual imp. I've made sure he'll never reach the outpost in one piece.
The only part I need is his trigger finger, Erwin. You'll see.
Whoa.
Whoa, indeed.
Incoming!
You're nearing the outpost now, Pac-Man. Erwin's forces are everywhere. There's a mine ahead, Pac-Man. There's a key you need in there, but Erwin knows that as well as I do.
His traps lack imagination, Orson. A few cage rods? No problem.
It's been a while, Orson. I've been looking forward to seeing you again, though I regret that I won't be able to stay for long. You notice, slime ball brains?
We worked together once, a long time ago. I was studying the spectral realm, and he wanted to create a perfect energy source. We shared some information.
It's ironic, isn't it? How our two dreams became one. I have my energy source, and you're losing your precious spectral realm. Now that's what I call perfect.
What's up with this?
This machinery was built a long time ago, Pac-Man. Even I don't understand it all. You probably have to activate something else first.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Oh dear! The spectral realm really isn't holding up very well. I guess maybe I should stop siphoning soon.
Yes, stop now before it's too late for us all, you madman!
Soon is when I make it, Spooks. And for now, I want more power! More!
Quit your daydreaming, Munchie. Come on, Orson needs you pronto-like.
Whoa! You're just in time, my pastel friends. There's no time to lose.
You better be right about him being our only hope for survival, because dragging him all the way in here was a real hassle, chump.
What can I do for you?
We're in one tight spot, Pac-Man. Erwin's evil army has almost reached this very outpost. And if it goes, the entire planet will soon follow.
Yeah, so get in this thingamabob.
Thingamabob? Clyde, Togman is a Model 420 tri-cylinder micro-tolerance combat mechanoid. And if it didn't need a pilot to be functional, I'd adopt it as my very own son this second.
In ya go, and don't mess this up. Shotgun! Never thought you and me would both be on the same side of a power pellet, Munchie. Guess this is pretty historic.
I'm happy for you. Keep your eyes on the road there, Pokey. Don't worry about your whatchamathingy, Orson. I'll go easy on her.
Good luck, Pac-Man! And try to bring Talkman back in one piece! Two at most!
Close, but no cigar, Orson. At least I can actually see the siphon. And I guess this is preferable to being teleported inside solid rock or something.
Exactly! It simply wasn't safe to port you right next to it, Pac-Man. The auxiliary gyrotoid is acting up, and as for the third ulterior exoprobe, I think it's on its last legs.
I'm here to destroy a siphon, yes? And then what?
That I can help with. Further energy sources within Erwin's fortress. It's near here, and you have to, get inside. Sorry.
I'd better get on with it, then.
Light! Fresh air! Oh, how good it feels! Let me look upon you, my fellow free creature, you wonderful little yellow ball. I'm sorry, what are you exactly?
I'm Pac-Man,
Why are you holding a spoon?
This is my salvation, the tool of my liberty from the mighty fortress, away from the clinking chains, the burning eyes. Oh, those burning eyes, red and glowing in the darkness. They see everything, everything.
So you dug your way out of Erwin's fortress with spoons?
They whisper to you, whispered in whirs and whistles. They tried to take my mind. Oh, yes. They didn't get it, though. Didn't get it.
Okay, I'm not sure about that. Anyway, you clearly need some alone time. Goodbye!
Watch out for the burning eyes!
I'm getting spectral readings in this area, Pac-Man.
Ah, spectrals! I've seen them! They come through the walls!
Did you make a new friend, Pac-Man?
I guess so.
I can help. A mighty hero, I, captured and enslaved, but later to escape. My knowledge of the fortress beyond is indelible. I have a map for a mind and compasses for feet. Direction is my middle name.
Could that be true, I wonder?
His feet are perfectly normal, Boris. It's the machinery at the other end that has issues.
I meant the mighty hero part, but never mind.
Ain't these chaps just the cutest? See them scamper, little legs all skittering. Can you bring me a little one for a pet?
My growing respect for you, Clyde, doesn't preclude my pointing out that sometimes you're just plain weird.
I know this looks bad, Munchie, but just remember, when the going gets tough, the tough get tougher. Failing that, they sneak around the back and kick a bit of...
That's enough, Clyde. Ready for interfacing, Pac-Man?
Depends entirely what you mean by that, horse. And the evil machine crumbles into the dirt.
You even impressed me back there, Pac-Man. Next up, Erwin's fortress. It's time to beard the dragon in his lair.
Beard? Dragon? What?
That way is fraught with danger, my good Pac-Man. Tread lightly, for things are not always what they seem. The walls, they move. They move when they think you're not looking.
Okay, then. Hope the mothership lands real soon.
I know he sounds like a gibbering idiot, but there might be something in what he says. I believe he did escape the fortress after all.
You want me to listen to a madman? Wait, what am I saying? Mad men, mad ghosts? Bring on the mad cats, dogs, and newts. I'll listen to you all.
Keep on upwards, Pac-Man.
You know your way around, fella?
I came this way. Extreme circumstances demand extreme escape, after all.
Sounds like you might just be some kind of hero. Nuts, brave.
Hero? Me? No. Well, no. Yes! Why not? Single-handedly, I stood against the tyrant Erwin and failed, but still I tried.
Yeah, and there's always that second chance.
Careful, Pac-Man.
I'm always careful.
Can you help Pac-Man once he's inside the fortress?
My specialty. These mountains, I know them barely, but the fort, I know completely.
Because you escaped from there, right?
Yes. Yes, that's right. So I did.
Oh, hello again. How did you get here?
I have knowledge of the ways, Pac-Man. Beyond this place lies the fortress of eyes and cutting, slicing, burning beams. You must be cautious and brave.
I must be out of my mind.
Move swiftly and luck be your companion.
Thanks, mister, but please tell me one thing. How did you get back here?
I don't know.
Now then, Pac-Man, I've located the final siphon, but there are some...
Do we have to talk now? I think they know I'm here.
Of course they do. All in a day's work, eh? The main problem I face is the age of these schematics.
The main problem you face? Orson, I'm busy. Call back later. I've got a couple of worlds to save. So much for infiltrating the fortress. They definitely know I'm here.
You're bright yellow, Pac-Man. Mark
you. Whoa! The doors!
I'm glad we met this guy. He's proving to be absolutely worth his weight.
It's apparently standard making it to Pac-Man. Rev roll play, big stuff move, you know the score.
Oh, the teeth! I can still feel the spike!
Good work, Pac-Man! Now, onward to the spike!
Patience, Orson. First with the fighting, then with the world.
I make the world what? No, shut up!
I learned the exact timing of these flame jets. I spent a whole day watching, concentrating, bearing the heat, memorizing the pattern.
And did it work?
Nope, got toasted. Hey, I never found this. But no one knows this fortress like I do.
There you are, Pac-Man. I can see you.
No, it's the boss. We're all going to die.
I recognize that voice.
Forget him and listen to me, Irwin. I've nearly won. I'm halfway through your supposedly impregnable fortress. How does it feel?
You confuse me. Who's your terrified friend? I'm sure I recognize the voice from somewhere. And he's right, of course. You are all going to die.
Uh-oh. I'm registering a significant power surge, Pac-Man.
One thing at a time, Orson. Sorry, Irwin. I've business to attend to.
Something's wrong.
He may be right, Pac-Man. It may be a trap.
No, no, no!
Orson, what's with the weather? This looks like the end of the world.
It seems that Irwin's little siphoning experiments have been having an adverse impact on meteorological outpourings in your proximity, Pac-Man.
And what about the weather?
Very funny. The final siphon reading is coming from the inner compound. Make your way across the outer walls and find a way in.
Try and die, Pac-Man. Try and die. Your puny little brain couldn't possibly comprehend what I have in store for the world.
Mass destruction, the closure of all chocolate factories, and the banning of kittens, perhaps.
That's just phase one. I have more stuff just waiting in the wings. My guards! My lovely robot guards! Oh, curse you, Pac-Man! Do you know how long it took to find the parts for those?
The parts are still fine, Irwin. They just need gluing back together.
What I want to know is, who's gonna clean up the mess? Like you're gonna get anywhere with that motley pack of second-rate spooks, Pac-Man! Give up now, and I might be persuaded to make your demise short and painful, instead of long and painful.
I like your style, Pac-Man. You're not too far away from the inner compound now and the spectral siphon.
There's just one thing I don't understand, Orson.
I'm sure there are many things you don't understand, Pac-Man. But go ahead.
Irwin's stupid, but he's not completely stupid. Why do you think he's willing to risk world catastrophe just to power a few robots?
I've no idea, Pac-Man. But I'm sure there's more to this than first appears. Just watch yourself. Irwin is becoming more unhinged by the minute. It's typical behavior from a socially inept would-be dictator.
Oh, yes. Very clever, Pac-Man. We're all very impressed. Oh, and by the way, I remembered who your insane little friend is.
Me? Why, I'm a brave resistance fighter, aren't I?
No, you're the janitor.
What? Janitor? How's that?
He's an employee, or moreover, an ex-employee. I checked his records. He was only here a week before we had to let him go.
I'm a hero, aren't I?
Sure you are, buddy. You helped me get this far. Hear that, Irwin? Maybe all it takes is a janitor in the wrong place at the wrong time, and all your plans come crashing down.
Or maybe my floors nearly get dirty.
That's the last of them, Pac-Man. Now let's get you into that siphon system real quick before any more turn up.
Just let me do my thing, Ors. Thank you, thank you. I'll be here all week. Hey, buddy. Hey, hero fella. We won!
You won? I should start cleaning up the mess.
I don't think so. I have need of somebody handy with a mop here at the outpost. Someone who,
though he was only an ordinary janitor, stood up for what he believed in. What do you say?
What sort of mop do you have?
A Gigamop 3 billion, with all the extras.
Shall I go and defeat the bad guy then? I guess I may as well. You guys enjoy your cleaning implements. I'll go and save the world.
This is not good. This is so seriously, indisputably, unbelievably not good. Pac-Man, the whole of the Spectral Realm is collapsing.
Not good.
Not good at all. If the Spectral Realm collapses, it'll break through to the real world. And that's the last anyone will have of kittens and chocolate and comfort and happiness for the foreseeable future.
We'll stop him, Orse. It'll be okay, you'll see. Orse, I have to ask. Didn't we beat Erwin already? I mean, his siphons are scrap, right?
It seems not, Pac-Man. This huge energy reading I'm seeing here, it has to be Erwin. Plus, the Spectral Realm is still degrading. Something's not right.
Orse, if Erwin has practically destroyed the Spectral Realm, is it a good idea for me to be here?
There's no other choice. It's the only way to penetrate the defenses Erwin has set up around the ancient temple. Erwin is repeating the mistake the ancients themselves made so many years ago. Breaching the meniscus of the Spectral Realm. Except he's doing it on purpose.
Nothing busts stress like busting Spectrals. That Pac-Man's been going light on you guys, I can tell. Yeah? Come on, I need a workout. It'd be a bleak day when a true ghost could be worried by Spectral Slime like you. You gotta be great to tangle with the big red hook machine. Take that, you spectral scroungers! Back to your dank little holes!
Orson, I can see a temple. Is that my target?
I believe so. You know, I didn't think the two worlds could come this close together and still survive. It must be near the end. We must stop Erwin now!
Okay. Over the top it is. Just catch me before I hit the ground!
Great. Yep. Excellent start.
Thank you.
Sorry, Pac-Man. A slight issue with the teleporter. A glitch in the Iwatani coil. Let's try again.
I'm gonna need a bigger power pellet. Time's up, Erwin. I'm coming for you.
And hurry along, irritant. It's about time I shut that big mouth of yours once and for all.
Enough, Erwin, you big bozo! You're gonna destroy us all!
Technically, no. My machines will keep me safe when the Spectral Realm crashes into the real world. It'll be dark and cold for a few years, but hey, do I look like I enjoy going out in the sun?
He's right, Pac-Man. The world will survive, but it'll be as dark as deep winter for years on end, and no one will be safe from the Spectral Monsters!
And my robot legions, powered by all that spectral energy, will be there to take over the whole world! That, and build huge statues of me. I kind of like statues. They make me look tall.
Well, it's a pretty clever plan, but... You're a loony! And I'm not gonna let you get away with it!
That's the stuff, Pac-Man! Oh, I've been looking forward to this bit! Get him!
Destroy my giant robot death machines. What did they ever do to you?
You're finished, Erwin. You should have used your death machines, world conquest plans, and rampaging insanity for good instead of evil.
It's finished, all right, Pac-Man. But only for one of us.
For you?
Well, yes, it's entirely possible when one considers things have not been going well. What am I saying? Even now, my magnificent machine is poised to bring about the collapse of the Spectral Realm and give my legions all the energy we need to. Why are you looking at me like that?
Always keep your feet on the ground, Erwin.
I always hated yellow. Mother!
Don't worry, hon. I have a hunch your father will be back right about...
Home sweet... Falling! Hi, honey. I'm home.
Clyde. Long time no see.
This birthday cake's delish, Mrs. Munchie. guess my party invite got lost in the mail.
It's Ms.
Hi,
Mrs. Munchie! Hooray, more ghosts. Well, guys, I'm afraid we only have enough cake for exactly none of you. If that.
Oh! Hey, look! This cake has Clyde in it! Yay, Clyde!
Cool! I never tried a Clyde cake before.
Was sorry to drop in like this, Ms. P, but we had nowhere else to go.
I assume you have a logical explanation for your whereabouts?
An insane little man with unresolved issues attacked the Spectral Realm. But he fell into a beam of raw power, so he won't be doing that again soon.
Aw, beams of raw power are cute.
Anyway, Orson's working on fixing up the Spectral Realm. We'll only be here a while, a few weeks, or months, tops. What's for dinner?
You are.
You heard the lady. I believe now's the part where you... run.
Oh, come on, Munchie. You don't want to eat me. But think of all we've been through together. Okay, bad example.